Welcome to Gartec's Electronics channel. Today we are going to discuss about bipolar junction transistors. From our previous tutorial on diodes, we learned that a diode has a positive side and a negative side which is marked by a stripe. We said that the positive side is called an anode while the negative side is called a cathode. Today we are going to discuss in detail about these diodes. I will try to make this tutorial as simple as possible so that you can get the most important points about diodes. We all know that diodes allow current to flow only in one direction. When diodes are forward biased, the current is allowed to flow, while when it is reverse biased, the current doesn't flow. Normal diodes are rated by the average forward current and the peak reverse voltage that they can handle. Always make sure to check the diode's datasheet to get the correct power ratings. There are several datasheet websites online, which includes www.alldatasheet.com. Since diodes are made from semiconductors such as germanium and silicon, a semiconductor diode, the most commonly used type of diode today, is a crystalline piece of semiconductor material with a p-n junction connected to two electrical terminals, where P stands for positive and N stands for negative. Diodes are used for various functions. For example, Zener diodes are used to regulate voltage, avalanche diodes are used to protect circuits from high voltage surges, varactor diodes are used to electronically tune radio and TV receivers, tunnel diodes, Gunn diodes, IMPATT diodes are used to generate radio frequency oscillations, and light-emitting diodes are used to produce light. Tunnel, Gunn and IMPATT diodes exhibit negative resistance, which is useful in microwave and switching circuits.
Bipolar transistor.
As we have seen, diodes are made up from two pieces of semiconductor material, either silicon or germanium, to form a simple p-n junction diode. Now if we join together two individual diodes back to back, this will give us two p-to-newtons junctions connected together in series that share a common p or n terminal. The fusion of these two diodes produces a three-layer PNP or NPN three-terminal device forming the basis of a bipolar transistor, which is abbreviated as BJT. There are two basic types of bipolar transistor construction, NPN and PNP. The three terminals of bipolar transistors are known and labeled as the emitter, abbreviated with letter E, the base, abbreviated with letter B, and the collector, abbreviated with letter C, respectively. For example, look carefully at this diagrams that I have drawn of bipolar junction transistors. Remember we said that letter P stands for the anode and letter N stands for the cathode. Diagram A shows a PNP type of transistor and diagram B shows NPN type of transistor. The current moves from positive terminal to negative terminal just as the standard diode. Therefore, you should always note that in bipolar transistors, the arrow points from P section to N section. Now, take a good look at this drawings. Do you see the difference in the direction where the arrows are pointing? The horizontal line represents the base, the angular line with the arrow on it represents the emitter, and the other angular line represents the collector. The direction of the arrow on the emitter distinguishes the NPN from the PNP transistor. If the arrow points inwards, the transistor is a PNP. On the other hand, if the arrow points outwards, the transistor is an NPN. Another point that we should remember from our tutorial about diodes is that diodes can be biased forward and they can also be biased in the reverse. Therefore, transistors also can be biased forward and in the reverse. In bipolar junction transistors, the current enters the transistor through the emitter such that the emitter base junction is forward biased and the collector base junction is reverse biased. Bipolar transistors work as current controlled or voltage controlled regulators. In other words, transistors restrict the amount of current or voltage passed according to a smaller, controlling voltage or current. The main current that is controlled goes from collector to emitter, or from emitter to collector, depending on the type of transistor it is, NPN or PNP, respectively. The small current that controls the main current goes from base to emitter, or from emitter to base, Once again, depending on the kind of transistor it is, NPN or PNP, respectively. The small, controlling current is usually referred to simply as the base current because it is the only current that goes through the base wire of the transistor. Conversely, the large, controlled current is referred to as the collector current, because it is the only current that goes through the collector wire. Since a bipolar junction transistor is a three-terminal device, there are three ways to connect it within an electric circuit while one terminal is the same for both output and input. You should note that, every method of connection responds differently to the input signals within a circuit. 1.
Common emitter configuration has both voltage and current gain.
2.
The common collector configuration has no voltage gain but has a current gain.
3.
The common base configuration has no current gain but has a voltage gain.
An easy way to identify a specific transistor configuration is to follow three simple steps. 1. Identify the element, emitter, base, or collector, to which the input signal is applied.
2.
Identify the element, emitter, base, or collector, from which the output signal is taken.
3.
The remaining element is the common element and gives the configuration its name. Thank you for watching this tutorial on transistors. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more video updates.